Hello, my name is Michael. I'm an educator here at Ripley's Aquarium Canada. I'm so happy to talk to you about the amazing axolotls we have at our aquarium. Let's learn a-LOTL. The axolotl is a type of salamander. They have a unique appearance with extended gills on either side of their head, four small limbs, and a fin that runs along their whole body to the tip of their tail. The name axolotl comes from the lore of an Aztec god named Axolotl, who represents the god of lightning, fire, and death. The Aztec words translate to water dog in English. Today, we are going to learn a lot about these awesome amphibians. Let's dive in! The axolotl's color typically ranges from black to brown, and sometimes gray with black spots. This coloring helps them camouflage into their murky water surroundings.
Wait, what about the iconic pink axolotls?
Pink variants are often mistaken as albino axolotls. However, these animals simply have lost their dark brown and black pigment in their body. In fact, pink or lighter colored axolotls are selectively bred by humans. Do you wonder how axolotls got to be so cute? In science, we call this neoteny, which refers to animals that keep their larval traits in their adult stage. Axolotls retain the tadpole-like shaped tail and also their distinctive extended gills even in their adult stage. Other amphibians, such as frogs and salamanders, will go through the metamorphosis and transform their body structure as they switch from aquatic to terrestrial life in their adult stage. They lose their larval traits as they grow, like replacing their gills with air-breathing lungs.
So, where in the world can we find axolotls? Axolotls live their whole life in freshwater lakes and swamps.
They have a very limited natural range, once only being found in the Lake Xochimilco and Lake Chalco, habitats of Mexico. However, most of these areas are now covered with buildings, infrastructures, and paved with roads. Due to urbanization, both lakes have shrunk much smaller than they once were. Axolotls in the wild are now only found in Lake Xochimilco and a few water canals under Mexico City. It is unfortunate to see their population decreasing so drastically in nature. However, they have been thriving under human care. Axolotls are generally easy to care for because they require minimal maintenance. We are happy to home two axolotls in our aquarium's shoreline gallery. A pink one named Mike Jr. and a black one named Kevin Jr.
Their names come from our fin-tastic managers, the director of husbandry, Kevin, and the manager of life support system, Mike, who built these vast exhibits for these amphibians.
Axolotls primarily consume fish, insects, mollusks, or even other axolotls in nature. Our animal care team feeds our axolotls three times a week, providing them with a healthy diet of earthworms, bloodworms, and pellets, making sure they receive all the nutrients they need. December to June is the mating season for axolotls. When an adult male meets a female, he will perform a stage of courtship by touching the female's axolotl's hindquarter, then shake his tail side to side to perform a dance. The male needs to perform a nice axolotl dance to attract the females to mate. I call it the axolotl dance-a-lotl. Once fertilized, females start laying eggs. The females will lay anywhere from 50 to 1500 eggs on aquatic vegetation or any submerged surface. During this period, the embryos will develop their gills and tails. When the axolotl hatch, they start their life in the larval stage. Their extended gills become fully developed, which allows them to breathe underwater. Then they will start growing the limbs that help them swim in the water in juvenile stage. Finally, when they are fully mature, they will get to about 25 centimeters in length and keep their juvenile traits.
Besides their popular appearance, axolotls are famous for their superpower, regeneration.
They can grow back damaged body parts and organs such as the spines, limbs, heart, lungs, and even part of the brain without a permanent scar. If the axolotl's limb is injured, they will go through 7 stages to regenerate another limb. Their 7-stage limb regeneration process takes about 4 to 8 weeks, during which their injured limb grows a transparent bandage to protect the site of injury from further damage while the healing process. Cells at the injury site will differentiate, meaning it will lose specialized characteristics, and can change from the stem cells to blastoma cells.
Stem cells are the cells with the potential to develop into anything in the body. Blastoma cells are specifically for regeneration. The blastoma cells will eventually become tissues, bones, blood vessels, veins, and then digits. With such extraordinary regenerating ability, they are one of the most studied animals by scientists. This helps not only understand the species, but also offers insight to potential medical applications or treatments for humans. For example, axolotl oocytes, eggs that are in early development, have genes and proteins that have been proven to help the human body effectively fight off cancer cells. With the adorable smiling baby face, axolotls are one of the most famous animals worldwide. They've been featured in Minecraft and inspired characters in How to Train Your Dragon and Pokemon. We even can find an axolotl on a Mexican $50 bill. Unfortunately, even with their fame in pop culture, these animals are critically endangered. Their population has been declining for centuries, and only less than 1,000 individuals are living in the wild today. The major threats axolotls face in the wild are habitat degradation and water pollution. Other factors like invasive species and climate change also contributes to their population decline. Urbanization has negatively impacted their environment the most and caused much of their habitat loss. Lake Xochimilco and Lake Chalco were once connected and adjacent to each other. However, due to human development, Lake Xochimilco has shrunk much smaller than it used to be, and Lake Chalco has been drained and destroyed completely. Extreme weather conditions and droughts due to climate change have also led to their habitat loss. In addition, agricultural and industrial activities causing water pollution in Lake Xochimilco also killed most of the aquatic life. So it is really hard for the axolotls to restore the population in their natural habitat. The local government and NGOs are trying the best to protect the axolotls in Mexico City by building small artificial islands called chinampas. Chinampas are made of aquatic vegetation, lake mud, and logs. This will help filter out the polluted water. The Mexican government also set up a protected natural area around Lake Xochimilco to safeguard remaining axolotls in the site. This area is also considered as a UNESCO World Heritage Site and a Ramsar Wetland International Importance. But what can we do to help axolotls? Reducing our carbon footprint daily would help slow down the effects of climate change. For example, try to take public transportation to school or work rather than each person driving their own car. Axolotls are absolutely amazing, from their unique lawful traits to their regenerative superpower. These critical endangered species are truly special, and we want to protect these species so our future generations will have a chance to see it. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next time in Ripley's Aquarium of Canada.